Good afternoon, student. Today we will be discuss about in last lecture Eschenmann reactions. Eschenmann reaction means unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Unimolecular means one molecular substitution, single molecular substitution reactions. Those student unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions conditions are following conditions are required. First condition is condition of Eschenmann reaction. First condition is tertiary butyl group or tertiary halide group must be required. Tertiary halide means any halide, fluorine, fluorine, bromine, iodine, any halide group must be required. Tertiary halide group must be present. Tertiary halide group must be present in your reactions. Second, aqueous protic solvent KOH must be required. And third, first tertiary halide group must be present. Second, aqueous protic solvent must be required. And mechanism in these reactions, first example are these reactions. Example is tertiary group tertiary halide are tertiary chloride. Example, tertiary chloride and aqueous KOH, aqueous. This Eschenmann reaction, newly molecular nucleophilic substitution reaction, are two step reaction. First step is tertiary halide group tertiary chloride group. First step are tertiary chloride group is present. And this step is the leaving group is chloride is removal of the tertiary group and get formation of tertiary carbocation. Formation of tertiary carbocation. Tertiary carbocation is most stable carbocation. For example, stability of carbocation is stability of carbocation. Tertiary, secondary, and primary. Those students, tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary, and secondary is more stable than primary. Primary carbocation is less stable. They are used to the Eschenmann reaction, not used to the Eschenmann reaction. Eschenmann reaction is only followed by the tertiary carbocation, and tertiary carbocation is give the product of Eschenmann reaction. So second step is first step. You can understand first step is leaving group are removal and then formation of tertiary carbocation. It is most stable carbocation. And second step, another one is most first carbocation. First step is Eschenmann reaction is rate determining step. Rate depend upon starting material, does not depend on in nucleophile, only depend on starting material. Because the tertiary carbocation is most stable and is self removing leaving group and formation of tertiary carbocation, that will be RDA step and rate determining step, does not depend on rate is nucleophile. Next step is फॉर्मेशन ऑफ टर्शियरी कार्बोकेटाइन दैट then will be attack of aqueous KOH. KOH means K plus OH minus form. This is form of KOH. K plus OH minus. It is nucleophilic nature. Then will be attack then tertiary carbocation. OH minus is attacked by tertiary carbocation. Then formation of tertiary alcohol. Formation of tertiary alcohol group. Tertiary alcohol group. Got it? Then repeat this reaction. SN1 reaction is unimolecular nucleophilic substitution reaction. Unimolecular nucleophilic substitution means one self molecule, single molecule reaction. Condition is tertiary halide group must be required. Halide means any halide, bromide, chloride, iodide. And then second is aqueous protic solvent are KOH, NOH, oblique NaOH is required. Then example is tertiary halide, tertiary chloride group are tertiary chloride group and plus KOH solvent. This two step reaction. First step is red determining step reaction. It is slow step and the red depend upon starting material, does not depend on nucleophile. This first step is self removable group in halide is easily removed and formation of tertiary carbocation. And then second step is tertiary carbocation is formation and nucleophile is KOH present in reaction. Then KOH minus is attacked by the tertiary carbocation and that give the product is tertiary alcohol. That is all. Thank you.